Accuracy is an obvious issue with our computer-based solution. So, to check what the computer does, the easiest way to learn what goes wrong with a computer simulation is to use a toy example which we can compute by hand as well. And this toy example will be a circular orbit, a spacecraft moving around Earth, for instance, with the Earth at the center of this orbit. Let's call the radius of that orbit r, and let's call the orbital period, the time it takes for one orbit, capital T. The velocity vector of that spacecraft will be tangential to that orbit, and the speed, that is the length of that velocity vector, the speed will be constant. And we can easily compute the speed. It takes the spacecraft amount of time, capital T, to go around that circumference. In the time, capital T, the distance traveled by the spacecraft is 2πr, the circumference of that orbit. The acceleration vector always points perpendicular to that orbit, to the center of the Earth. The acceleration does not change the speed, the length of the velocity vector, that is. It simply changes the direction of that vector. We can compute the length of that acceleration vector in a similar fashion. This goes as follows. We start with the velocity vector that takes us up. And then we move, and then the velocity vector changes to the left. At this point, it points to the left. And eventually it goes round full circle. After one orbital period, it's going to be that blue vector again, with a phase shift of 90 degrees. So we can say that the velocity vector executes the same circular motion as does the position vector, but we have a phase shift of 90 degrees between them. Nonetheless, we can still apply the same equation. It takes us one orbital period to make one full revolution, and that has a length of 2 pi times the speed. All of these vectors have a length of 2 pi r divided by t. So the circumference would be 2 pi times this radius, 2 pi r divided by t, which boils down to 2 pi squared r divided by t squared. So given the radius and the orbital period of that circular motion, we can determine what the speed is and what the acceleration is.